हेलो एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। आई एम उस्मान जावेद एंड आई एम अ लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट कॉम्प्लेक्स यूनिवर्सिटी इस्लामाबाद। ऑन द स्क्रीन यू कैन सी माय ईमेल एड्रेस एंड माय व्हाट्सएप नंबर सो दैट यू मे कॉन्टैक्ट मी। So, first of all, let me clarify that why should you consider studying this course. So, there are four points which I will discuss briefly. The first is the introduction of the fundamental concepts of renewable energy and alternate sources and discussion of trends, the trends which are related to energy consumption, specifically speaking energy consumption of the whole world. On the second is the illustration of the challenges that world faces with respect to the supply and the environment. On the third, we will emphasize on the design of renewable energy sources and alternative energy power plants. And fourth one is the discussion of economics of renewable energy and alternative energy system. So first of all, let's see what are the latest energy consumption trends. The blue line or the blue graph on the top indicates the curve for the energy consumption that is being created using oil, or to be precise, fossil fuels, petrol, diesel and natural gas. Most of our energy consumption is fulfilled by the use of oil, and the poisonous gases which are produced by burning oil have a very harmful effect on our environment. On the second number, the graph line, black one, indicates the energy consumption with respect to coal. It is on the second. Also, it contributes a lot towards pollution. The third curve, purple one, indicates the energy consumption that is derived from natural gas. In our country, many of the textile mills and sugar mills use gas energy and diesel energy. To fulfill their energy requirements. The red one and the green one, they are the nuclear energy and the other renewable energy resources. This graph from 1965 to 1985 indicate that there is no use of renewable energies and nuclear energy, and from 1985 to 2005 the nuclear energy and the other renewable energy resources, their graph tends to increase a little bit. And after that, the nuclear energy trend is going downwards and the other renewable energy resources trend is on the rise. The nuclear energy trends are decreasing for obvious reasons. The main challenge that humanity will ever face is the shortage of energy, because in each and every field of our life, human beings are heavily dependent on energy consumption. And once the oil, coal, and gas resources are depleted from this world, we will only be left to choose the renewable energy or the nuclear and other renewable energy resources. Now, this is the oil supply and demand curve from the year 2015 to 2019. MBD stands for million barrels per day. This is the unit on y-axis, and on the x-axis, these are the years 2015, 16, 17, 18, and 19. The blue bars indicate the total stocks that are available to the world. They may show a rise and fall. Whenever new resources are discovered, these graphs tend to rise. Also, the yellow one is the demand curve and the green curve is the supply curve. In ideal scenarios, the supply curve should be a little higher than the demand curve. But whenever the supply curve is below and the demand curve is above, it means that the demand exceeds the supply, the oil prices tend to go higher. For instance, if we consider the recent scenario of COVID-19, the whole world was shut down and the demand for the oil was significantly reduced, but the supply was there, and therefore, due to higher supply and lower demand, the fuel prices were significantly dropped. These are some of the examples for alternative energy resources, or we may call them renewable energy resources. The first one is the geothermal energy. Thermal means heat and geo means geography or earth. So the geothermal energy means the energy or the heat energy that is stored in Earth's crust or any other planet's crust, and the most common example of geothermal energy is thermal geysers. The second most common form of renewable energy is the wind energy. These are little wind turbines, and when the wind moves, it will rotate these windmills, and their generators or turbines will generate electricity. The third one is the hydroelectric, in which we use to build dams, and then the flow of water turns the turbine, which in turn produce the electricity. The next one is the solar energy, in which the sunlight is producing electricity when it gets to hit the solar panels. The other form of energy that we can use is the biomass. By using biomass, we create methane, and methane gas is burned to use it as a fuel. And the last one is the nuclear energy. Most of the time, I will be using online resources for this particular course, but the textbook for this course is The Renewable Energy Technology, Economics and Environment by M. Kartmann, W. Fesher, and E. Weiss. And the other reference textbooks include Renewable Energy Policy by Paul Komore. I would suggest you to take regular notes during lecture hours and contribute in Q&A session actively. I will provide you the slides and other reading materials through MS Teams. So these are the course learning outcomes of this particular course. There are basically four course learning outcomes. The first one is C2, means cognitive level 2. Cognitive level 2 is a lower order in Bloom's taxonomy, and it stands for comprehension. So basically, you will be able to comprehend things, and the details of this first course learning outcome is that you'll be able to list and generally explain that what are the energy principles and what are the main source of energy, what are the primary applications of energy, what are the main sources like oil and gas, and what are the secondary or renewable energy resources like solar or wind and hydro. So this is the course learning outcome number one. So it will be comprehension based. The second course learning outcome is C3. C3 in Bloom's taxonomy is the cognitive level 3, and it stands for application. Its domain is in higher order. And in this course learning outcome, you will be able to demonstrate the challenges that world faces during various energy source uses, including fossil fuels and other sources like fuel cells. They have economical challenges to face. And the third one is the design and development solution that includes primary renewable energy technologies. The course learning outcome number 3 is based on C5, and C5 in Bloom's taxonomy stands in higher order domain, and its cognitive level 5 indicates that you will be able to synthesize and design and develop different solutions for already standing outstanding problems that are being faced by the world related to renewable energy technologies. The fourth one is C4. In Bloom's taxonomy, the cognitive level 4 stands for analysis. And in this course learning outcome, you will be able to analyze and evaluate the statistics on which the renewable energy technologies in terms of feasible economics and environment in the larger energy mix picture. As I talked earlier, for instance, about fuel cells, they are facing economical challenges because implementation of an energy plant using fuel cell is quite expensive. The next is the program learning outcome. The program learning outcomes are the description of the knowledge and competencies and values that a student displays at the end of the program. The program learning outcomes are helpful for students to understand that why this knowledge and these competencies will be useful for them. There are four program learning outcomes for this particular course that we are expecting the students to attain. The first program learning outcome is the engineering knowledge. Being an engineer, a student should be able to apply the knowledge of mathematics, science, engineering, fundamentals, and the engineering specialization to the solution of complex engineering problem. Let me clarify that a complex engineering problem is a type of problem that is usually considered that which do not have any obvious solutions. The second program learning outcome is the problem analysis. In this program learning outcome, the student is expected to have an ability to identify, formulate the research literature and analyze complex engineering problem, reaching substantiated conclusions using first principle of mathematics, natural sciences and engineering sciences. The third program learning outcome is design and development of solution. By the end of this course, the student should have enough knowledge so that he or she may have an ability to design the solutions for complex engineering problems and design systems. Components or processes that meet specified needs with appropriate consideration of public health and safety, culture, society, and environmental consideration. The fourth program learning outcome is PLO7. According to the Bloom's taxonomy, and that is environment and stability. An ability to understand the impact of professional engineering solution in social and environmental context and demonstrate knowledge and need of sustainable development. According to the course learning outcomes, the following will be the topics that I intend to cover in this course. The first one is the introduction to energy, that what is energy and what are its basic units, the types of energy. For example, you have heard about the potential energy, the kinetic energy, heat energy, these types of things. And the other things are the energy related parameters, like their units and their importance in our daily life. The second one are the sources of energy, which includes the conventional sources of energy. The conventional source of energy include basic fossil fuels like petrol, diesel, gasoline and natural gases, and the renewable energy resources, which include wind energy, the tidal energy, etc. Then come the alternative energy sources like fuel cells, which use hydrogen as a fuel, but there is a debate that hydrogen cannot be extracted from the environment at low cost. Researchers are working on that. The environmental impact and of various energy sources, for instance, as I discussed earlier, that the burning of the fossil fuels emit a lot of dangerous gases that pollute our environment. The solar energy and solar power plant design, the wind energy and the wind power plant design, these two, the solar and the wind, they will be covered in course learning outcome number 3. The first three, which include the introduction to energy, their units and their types, they will be covered in course learning outcome number 1. And in course learning outcome number 4, we will cover the basic economic aspects of renewable energy sources. Economy growth is directly related to energy consumption. Now, let us quickly go through the assessment plan of marking. There will be one quiz and one assignment before sessional 1. After sessional 1, there will be two quizzes and two assignments before the department announces the date for the second sessional. There will be one quiz and one assignment between the sessional 2 and the final terminal exam. You should try to give your 100% in assignments and quizzes and try not to be late during the quiz and assignment submissions. The deadlines are absolute. Late assignments and late quizzes submission will be accepted, but 50% marks will be deducted for late submission. Now, let us talk about the marks distribution criteria of this particular course. As you know, this is a 3-credit hour course, so there will be no lab work related to it. However, you may be assigned a project or something like that that may contribute in your terminal marks. There will be 4 assignments and 4 quizzes. Then assignments will contribute to 10% of the total weightage and quizzes will contribute to 15% of the total weightage. Sessional 1 will contribute to 10% and sessional 2 will contribute to 15%. There will be no retake of sessional 1 and sessional 2. So avoid being late or absent on these two special sessions. The terminal exam will contribute to 50%. Following are the guidelines for attempting quizzes, assignments, and terminal examination of this course. First of all, be clear that plagiarism will not be tolerated. I will reject the plagiarized work. And once the student is caught with a plagiarized work, his future work will be suspected that he is involved in plagiarism this time also. Secondly, the assignments will be conceptual, because conceptual learning of sciences reflect our major goal to use the potential of modern technology in order to improve technology, knowledge, and understanding of the basic concepts which are related to science and technology, with a special focus on intuitive and qualitative approaches. Number three, you will earn your marks if you take your assignment seriously. And last but not the least, you must fulfill the attendance requirement. And one thing I should add, that whenever I post a link of these lectures, you must make a 3-line summary and email me before the Q&A session. I hope that this lecture has increased your knowledge and understanding about this course. You may ask questions in Q&A session or through WhatsApp, through my email or MS Teams, or whatever medium you may prefer. Thank you.